Good morning. Welcome to Victorious Faith. I'm Cherry Campbell. We are on a series that we've started this week that is a sequel to the series we completed, and that was the Law of Spiritual Authority that we talked about for 6 months. Now we're on a sequel to that series. The sequel is called The Spiritual Battle. The Spiritual Battle. And for the last couple days, few days, we have talked about the battle we are in, waging war, and our struggling is a spiritual struggle against the spiritual wickedness, rulers of darkness. We talked about know your enemy. Your enemy is not God. Your enemy is not flesh and blood, not your husband or your wife, not your father, mother, not your brother, sister, your son or daughter, not your boss or your coworker, not against any flesh and blood, but against Satan and the rulers of darkness, spiritual wickedness. And so we talked about how to deal with the devil, and you resist him, standing firm in the faith. 1 Peter 5:9. You cast him out in the name of Jesus, Mark 16:17, and you bind him in Jesus' name, Matthew 18:18. And so today I want to go on and talk to you about our armor, our spiritual armor. Now, I'm not going to go into a lengthy, detailed study of this, and I know that there are teachings on it. You can read books on it. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to summarize this part, the armor of God. And of course, the most familiar teaching in the Bible is in Ephesians chapter 6, verses 11 through 18. Let me read that to you. Ephesians 6:11. Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. That's the schemes of the devil. Other translations of the word wiles, the wiles of the devil. In the Basic Bible, it says the deceits. In the Complete Jewish Bible, it says the deceptive tactics of the adversary. The Darby says the artifices of the devil. And the ESV, English Standard, says the schemes of the devil. Then God's Word Translation says the devil's strategies. The devil's strategies. And then there's other translations, tactics, schemes, strategies, wiles. And so we had already talked about, you need to know the tactics of the devil. You've got to know his strategies. You cannot fight any kind of battle if you don't know the tactics and strategies of the enemy. And so that's what this word means in Ephesians 6:11. Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles, the schemes, the deceits, the tactics of the devil, the evil one, the accuser. And then verse 12, we've read before, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. And there, wherefore, take unto you, or take upon yourself, the whole armor of God. That's verse 13. That you may be able to withstand, or that means simply stand in the day of evil, or the day of attack, or the day of wrestling, and having done all, to stand. So you take the armor of God. Why? So you may be able to stand. And having done all to stand, stand. And verse 14, stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth. Having on, and another translation says, having the belt of truth. Having the belt of truth. And then having on the breastplate of righteousness. And your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. And above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith you shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked or the evil one. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Verse 18 is included, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. And so we see there the armor of God. And let me read it to you again in another translation. Put on the full armor of God so you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. And of course, we've read 12 several times, skip to 13. Therefore, put on the full armor of God so that when the day of evil comes, that is when the day of struggling, wrestling, or his attack against you comes, you may be able to stand your ground, and after you have done everything, to stand. Verse 14, stand firm then. Now, we're back again. What is this battle that we are in? We talked about it earlier this week in 1 Timothy 6:12, fight the good fight of faith. The fight of faith is a standing firm in faith in the promises of God. Now, we're going to get to that again, but standing firm in faith in the promises of God, that is your fight of faith. It is a standing in faith, remaining in faith. So it says, put on the full armor of God so you can take your stand, and then stand firm then. Well, verse 13, again, therefore put on the full armor of God so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground. And after you've done everything, to stand. Now, this standing is not enduring in a hopeless condition that you just, okay, I'll make it to the end. It's not a survival mentality of just enduring a problem until you get to heaven. This is an overcoming attitude. This is a warfare attitude that says, I am getting the victory. I am winning this battle. It is an attitude of faith that believes you are the winner. You are the conqueror, and you are coming out on top, not on the bottom. This battle is not going to last forever. This battle is not going to last forever. It's not something, it is not an enduring, hopelessly attitude that nothing will ever change. We're just going to endure this problem for the rest of your life. No. Not at all. You have to get the attitude that this problem is changing. You are winning. You are coming out on top. You are getting the victory. Things are changing. You have to have a winner attitude, not an enduring attitude, enduring the problem for the rest of your life. No, that problem cannot stay. You are in a battle to resist and cast out and overcome that problem in your life. And so you have to have a conquering, overcoming, winning attitude. You are coming out of this situation, this problem is not going to last forever. And as a matter of fact, it's not even going to last very long at all. You're coming out right away. And you're coming out on top with the victory. Hallelujah. That's the attitude. That's what standing is all about. It's not a hopeless enduring your problem forever. It is a conquering attitude, a winning attitude. That's what standing firm is. Standing firm in your victory. Standing firm that Jesus has redeemed you from the curse, from sickness, from disease, from lack, from all the struggles that come from the enemy. You have the victory. That is your stand. And then verse 14, stand firm then with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fit with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows, that is the fiery darts, the flaming arrows of the evil one. Verse 17, take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Verse 18, and pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. And with this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the saints. Now let's break that down one piece at a time in the armor. Your armor, it begins with the belt of truth, which is the word of God. In John 17:17, Jesus was praying his prayer to the Father in John 17. Verse 17, he said, your word is truth. Your word is truth. And here we see the belt of truth. So truth is the word of God also. Your word is truth. And what does a belt do? A belt holds everything on and in place, so that things don't fall off or shift out of position. So it is a stabilizing force. The word of God, this belt of truth, in John 17:17, Jesus said, the word of God is truth. Your word is truth. So again, we are using the word. And it is the word which balances you. It is the word which holds everything in your life in place steady. You stay steady in the word. If you get off the word, you will vacillate. You get off the word, you will get tipsy. You'll get off. You get off the word and the rest of the armor and the areas of your life will start shifting out of place, out of their proper position and alignment. It is always the word of truth that lines you up. You have to line your life up to the word of truth, the belt of truth. Keep everything in your life aligned to the word of God. Keep everything in your life aligned to the word of God. We're saying that you have to always come back to the word of God every day. God's word is eternal. God's word is truth. It will show you the deceits of the evil one. If you don't have the word of truth, then you are easily deceived by the deceits of the evil one. The word of truth shines the light on the devil's deceits, exposes his deceits, brings them into the light so they are seen for what they are, their lies, their deceits, their his cunning and craftiness, his schemes. And it was because Eve and Adam did not go back to the word God said to them. God spoke a word to them. They did not go back to that word. So when the devil came with a deceit and a lie and a scheme, they were shifted off of the truth and they fell into his cunning scheme by falling for his deception. You will fall whenever you get off the word of truth. You will fall into the devil's cunning schemes and his deceitfulness if you ever get off the word of truth. You must keep the word of truth coming in your eyes, ears, and heart, meditating on it day and night, as it says in Joshua 1:8, so that you can always discern the deceit and the cunning scheme of the evil one. So that you can stand and not fall. So you don't fall into the trap of the enemy. The truth will always guard you. The truth will always keep you in balance. The truth, which is God's word. God's word of truth will keep you in balance, keep you aligned, keep everything in your life aligned straight. Be sure you keep the word of truth in your heart and mind every single day. Because when you don't keep the word of God coming in your heart, then you are easily deceived, like Adam and Eve, especially Eve, into the devil's schemes. And deceits and lies and traps, and then you will fall. You must keep the word of truth in your heart every day to keep your life steady, stable, and aligned. The next piece of armor is the breastplate of righteousness. Again, we've already talked about these things. You know, I was teaching for a year and a half foundational teachings before teaching you spiritual authority, because all these other things have to come first. We did the law of faith. We also did the authority of God's word, keeping your life on the authority of God's word, keeping his word as the ruler of your life, the standard of your life. And then we did a teaching about who you are in Christ, and we saw your position in Christ and your righteousness in Christ. Because your righteousness, that is your breastplate. What does the breastplate do? It guards your heart against the attacks of the enemy, against your heart. And he attacks you with guilt and condemnation, unrighteousness, unworthiness, shame, disgrace. And he tries to tear you down in your heart. So that you feel unworthy, unrighteous, shamed, disgraced. But you keep on your breastplate of righteousness, knowing who you are in Christ. You are the righteousness of God in Christ. You are washed in the blood, cleansed by the blood, purified by the blood, placed in Christ Jesus through faith in him. And he has raised you up and seated you with him. You must keep your righteousness intact. And I encourage you, go back. We did 2 weeks teaching on righteousness. We did 6 weeks on who you are in Christ. Keep your identity in Christ fresh in your heart and mind. Who you are in Christ. That is where it will guard your heart and mind, where you can stand steady against Satan's attacks against you, against your identity. And then comes the shoes of peace, the shoes of peace, the gospel of peace. Well, what is peace? It is walking in peace instead of strife, walking in love and peace. When you walk in strife, you're in confusion. James 3:16 says, where there is strife, there is confusion. And every evil work. If you let strife into your marriage, if you let strife into your family, if you let strife into your workplace and your job, what will it do? It brings confusion. James 3:16, where there is strife, there is confusion and every evil work. And if you're in confusion, you're in darkness. When you're in darkness, you're in the trap of the devil. You got to get out of darkness into the light. That means you have to get out of strife into peace. Don't allow strife for a minute in your life. Because when you're in strife, you're going to be in confusion in the battle. And when you're in battle and confusion, you don't know what to do. You don't know which way to turn, and you're in deception and darkness, and then the devil is able to trap you and take you captive, his captive. You don't want to be the devil's captive. Get out of strife. Get into peace. If you walk in the peace of God, then the peace of God will guide your steps into victory. Guide your steps into victory. The peace of God will guide your steps into victory. God will guide you. And then take up the shield of faith. We've talked about that. We talked about that in the Law of Faith series for 8 weeks. That is a large shield. It's a door-like shield that you can stand behind and be totally hidden behind it. It represents complete safety when you are standing in faith in the Word of God and in Jesus Christ. And this faith will quench all the arrows that come against you from Satan, the evil one. And so study the faith of God that we've talked about already for 8 weeks. The next piece of armor is the helmet of salvation. It's on your head. It's the awareness of your salvation. You know what's so funny about that? Is that there are millions of Christians today that they only know about their salvation. They are actually spiritually walking around naked with a helmet on. They are naked with a helmet on. They have a helmet and the rest of their body is naked because the only thing they know is salvation. The only thing they know is they're born again, going to heaven. They don't know their authority. They don't know their righteousness. They don't know their faith. They're not standing on the word. And so they're naked completely except with a helmet. You know, that looks pretty silly, doesn't it? You can imagine, very goofy, naked with a helmet. Don't do that. You should know more than your salvation. Know more than being born again. Know your authority. Know the righteousness that you have. Know the peace of God and walk in peace. Know the shield of faith and putting up your shield of faith. Know the belt of truth and you're standing girded in truth, not being shaken one way to the other, vacillating back and forth, standing firm on and in the truth of God. And then the next piece of that armor and weaponry is the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. That is your offensive weapon. That is the weapon you take to take up the sword of the Spirit. Take up the Word of God, speaking the Word of God in every situation. Every situation, you speak God's promises again and again, thousands of times a day if you need to. And then the last part of this armor and weaponry is in the last verse, praying in the Spirit, praying in the Spirit. In verse 18, praying in the Spirit, praying in tongues. This is how you pray about mysteries that you don't know, answers you don't know, solutions you don't know, even tactics of the enemy you don't know. You pray in tongues. According to 1 Corinthians 14:2, you're praying out the mysteries of God. These are the answers and solutions that you don't know in your head. You say, what am I going to do? Pray it out in tongues. Praying in the Spirit, praying in tongues gets the job done in situations that you don't know and understand by your natural knowledge. Now, if you've missed any of these previous teaching series that I've talked about or that you need to hear them again, I encourage you to do so. They are available on my website and YouTube channel. My website is victoriousfaith.co, victorious like a champion, victorious, faith, faith.co, co like Colorado. And go to the radio broadcast archive page, or there are also available on my YouTube channel. Go to YouTube, type in my name, Cherry Campbell, C-H-E-R-R-I, Campbell, C-A-M-P-B-E-L-L. My channel is under my name, Cherry Campbell. Go to the channel. You will see all of these previous teaching series that I've done on this radio program listed there on the YouTube channel and website. The series that I've talked about, Resurrection Week, where we studied what happened from the cross to the throne and Jesus' defeat of Satan in death and hell and the grave and his victory. Also, who we are in Christ and our righteousness in Him, and we are the sons of God. Also, the law of faith and the shield of faith that we've talked about. Also, the baptism in the Holy Spirit and praying in tongues and the power and benefits of tongues. Millions of Christians have not yet received this gift, and they don't even know that it's for everyone. I answer probably every question you could think of about tongues because I have studied it and taught it for years, and it will help you to get the answers you need. I encourage you to pray in tongues every single day. It is your most powerful weapon. It is the most powerful kind of prayer, is praying in tongues. And also, real quickly, I just want to remind you about our bookstore on our website. Go to the website and go to the bookstore tab. We have over 2,000 books in our bookstore now of authors that you know and love. Joel Osteen, T.D. Jakes, Beth Moore, Joyce Meyer, and so many others that you would know, and also Bibles and devotionals. Go to the website and go to the bookstore to buy your books today. Now join me again tomorrow, and remember, God loves you. You're blessed and highly favored by the Lord.